So like every solid tumor, bladder cancer comes in a low stage, stage one, stage two, and then later stages, stage three and stage four. The way that I think about this and the way that we use a multidisciplinary approach to treat bladder cancer with our surgical colleagues is really whether or not the tumor is invading into the muscle layer of the bladder, and that is stage two. So those early stage tumors that are carcinoma in situ or non-muscle invasive, a stage one tumor, are handled with intravesical therapy or topical therapy on the inside of the bladder, whereas stage two and beyond, it's a multidisciplinary approach between urology, medical oncology, and sometimes radiation. So most patients with bladder cancer find out that they have the disease because they have blood in their urine, and they seek care with either their primary care physician first or directly to a urologist. The biopsy that diagnoses bladder cancer is called a TURBT, and that's done by a urologist. Based on the stage, a urologist will refer certain patients who meet eligibility criteria based on their stage or on their interest or comfort level with a medical oncologist. I'm a medical oncologist and I give medical therapy, both intravenous therapy as well as oral therapy for bladder cancers. The current standard of care for muscle-invasive bladder cancer is for qualifying and eligible patients to get a cisplatin-based chemotherapy prior to surgery and then go ahead and get surgery. For certain patients, we can actually incorporate chemotherapy with radiation therapy to treat the bladder. In the postoperative setting, for patients who've gotten preoperative chemotherapy and we find that we feel like they need additional treatment based on the stage of the tumor, for certain patients, we can offer postoperative immunotherapy. That's a new standard based on research done within the last year. For patients with tumors that progress beyond that perioperative therapy, or for patients who present with metastatic disease, we have a variety of different kinds of treatments: chemotherapy, targeted therapy, which is an oral treatment, intravenous immunotherapy called checkpoint inhibitors, as well as a targeted chemotherapy called antibody drug conjugates, as well as other treatments on the horizon with clinical trials here at Hopkins and beyond. Bladder cancer tumors can reoccur. For non-muscle invasive cancers, it's a standard of care for urologists to perform follow-up cystoscopies or looks inside the bladder, because a treated tumor can at some point recur inside the bladder or actually even to the upper tracts that comprised of the ureter and the renal pelvis, which is the inside lining of the kidney. In addition, those tumors could come back in the metastatic space, particularly for patients, though, who have a muscle-invasive cancer. So our standard surveillance paradigm for patients with a muscle-invasive bladder cancer who've gotten that aggressive local therapy, whether or not it's chemotherapy and surgery or chemotherapy and radiation, would be to follow them with imaging. And that's typically a CAT scan for most patients every few months for the first few years after their diagnosis. As time goes on, we can lengthen the intervals between those scans as the likelihood of recurrence goes down with time. The patients that we offer chemotherapy to are those with a high-grade muscle-invasive bladder cancer, and also those who are fit for chemotherapy. So really both the disease and the patient characteristics really have to combine. Not all of our patients are good candidates for our standard of care chemotherapy, because the current standard of care chemotherapy for early stage muscle invasive bladder cancer is a drug called cisplatin, and that can have a lot of toxicity or side effects that is not well handled by all patients. It's in part why we're doing research to look at other medications that may be used in that early setting. For patients with later stage bladder cancer, we consider alternatives like carboplatin, immunotherapy, antibody-drug conjugates, as well as oral targeted therapies that can be used in sequence. In my mind, radiation therapy or local therapy that we can use for bladder cancer has a few different indications. The main one is for a minority of patients that have a muscle invasive bladder tumor that is unifocal, which means there's one tumor, it's small, it's completely resected by that transurethral resection by the urologists, and there's no indication that there's blockage of the ureters. For those patients, something called trimodality therapy where the bladder can be spared is an option. We do that as a part of standard of care as well as in clinical trials here at Hopkins and across the country. So that's a clear indication for patients who want to keep their bladder who have a muscle invasive bladder cancer. We also will sparingly use radiation as a tool to treat some of our patients with later stage disease who may have a painful bone lesion or another lesion that clearly may be amenable to radiation therapy in addition to systemic therapy.